follow.
Curtsy.
Several small obligations I can't avoid.
Princess, the time.
A few rules to welcome, more than a few commitments by the score. Aside from all that, though, I'm overjoyed.
This way, princess.
Because this welcoming ceremony is just the beginning. Tomorrow's the festival, followed by the royal banquet, and that's all before the actual coronation on Sunday. Oh, come on. Really? Look, Rapunzel, I know this princess thing is new to you, but you've gotta at least try to act the part.
Trust me, Cassandra, I know how important this is to my dad.
As you've requested, Your Majesty, we doubled security on both the main gates and the south towers.
Good. We have guests from all over the world. I want them to know that they are safe. Everything for my little girl's coronation weekend must be absolutely perfect.
Hi, Dad.
And now that at last you are here in my arms, I won't permit you to fall. I must protect you from all the world's harms. We'll live happily ever after all. Now, as princess, you are not only representing yourself and the family, but all of Corona.
Don't worry, Dad. I won't let you down. But while we're on the whole princess coronation thingy, I mean, all these royal activities are great, but do you think I might be able to catch a little downtime soon?
I know this is all new, but you'll adjust. After all, your friend seems to be getting on just fine.
Ooh, Helmut, my man! This hat ties the whole outfit together. Now, I know what you're all thinking. Why is Eugene in such a good mood today? I mean, what gives? Now that we're living splendidly, our dreams fulfilled extendedly, why leave things open-endedly for Rapunzel and moi? Tonight I'll hand this rose to her, kneel down and then propose to her, and give this ring I chose to her.
Nice.
Life's gonna be like strawberry sherbet when she is Mrs. Eugene Fitzherbert. Okay, not great, but how about this? Once she is Princess Eugene Fitzherbert! And what better day to propose to a princess than at her coronation?
This is life after happily ever after. And our story has finally reached its end.
Settling down here,
year upon year,
contented and secure.
Just introducing myself to the most important people in the world. Representing my mom, dad, and the entire kingdom. We got this.
There's nothing rich folks love more than going downtown and slumming it with the poor. They pull up in their carriages and gawk at the students in the common just to watch them talk. Take Philip Skynor, the man is loaded. Uh-oh, but little does he know that his daughters, Peggy, Angelica, Eliza, stay in the city just to watch all the guys.
Angelica!
Shouting in the
looking for a mind in work. I'm looking for a mind in work. I'm looking for a mind in work. Wow, 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 work.
Ooh, there's nothing like summer in the city. Someone in a rush, sniffing, someone looking pretty. Excuse me, miss, I know it's not funny, but your perfume smells like your daddy's got money. While you slumming in the city in your fancy ears, you searching for an urchin who can give you ideals.
Sir, you disgust me.
Ah, so you disgust me. I'm a trust fund baby, you can trust me.
I've been reading Common Sense by Thomas Paine. Some men say that I'm intense or I'm insane. You want a revolution, I want a revelation. So listen to my declaration. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. And when I meet Thomas Jefferson, I'ma compel him to include women in the sequel. Work! Look around, how lucky we are to be alive right now. Look around, and how lucky we are to be alive right now. History is happening in Manhattan, and we just happen to be in the greatest city in the world. In the greatest city in the world.
I go up.
Bruno says it looks like rain.
Whiskey-tella.
In doing so, he floods my brain.
I'm like a sea umbrella.
Thank you. Harui!
What? I'm clearly trying to leave in a dramatic way.
There's something I need you to know. You once told me you never actually had feelings for me. It was all just a trick. Maybe that's true. But my feelings for you are real.
Then why didn't you come for me?
I did! I understand you hate me, and maybe I deserve it, but either way... So, I'll just be going now. Sorry, Ruby.
No, I'm sorry, Lloyd.
The answer to that question is complicated. We'll address it in due time. But for now, you may refer to me as Vesper.
Okay, Vesper. Why am I here? How did I get here? Where is here? Why does this place look like...
Enough! Gentlemen? Ah, crap, singing. Mind if I smoke?
Cigars are evil, you won't miss them. We'll find ways to simulate that smell. What a sorry fella, rolled up and smoked like a granitella. Here on level one of robot hell.
I gotta get out of here.
You're not going anywhere!
Gambling's wrong, and so is cheating, so is forging phony IOUs. Let's let Lady Luck decide what type of torture's justified. I'm Pit Boss here on level two.
Ooh, deep-fried robots.
Just tell me why. Please read this 55-page warrant.
There must be robots worse than I.
We checked around, there really aren't.
Then please let me explain. My quads were merely boys' ranks.
You stole from Boy Scouts, nuns and banks.
Ah, stop, blame me. Blame my upbringing.
Please stop singing while I'm singing. Selling bootleg tapes is wrong. Musicians need that income to survive.
Hey, men are gonna make some noise with your hard drive backed by the Beastie Boys. What you get on level 5?
I don't feel well.
It's up to us to rescue him.
Maybe he likes it here in hell.
It's us who tempted him to sin.
Maybe he's back at the motel.
Come on, Fry, don't